Good morning, chat. Welcome everyone back to the stream. Sorry, plot twist started playing. Welcome to stream chat. Today is this is June 3rd. It has officially been 1 year since I released Cryon Inc. Now this is cool. It's a little cool. So yeah, first thing we're gonna do a full story reading. Jesus, Criminy Arcade. You're taking up my entire, like, chat screen with woo. So, first thing we're gonna do... Oh god, stream's dying already. That's great. I hope it doesn't die. I tested it. I try to make sure everything's, like, more than Gucci. It looks good. So, hopefully it doesn't die. So, first thing we're gonna get into, we're gonna do the story reading, and then we're gonna get into the presentation. Hopefully that takes up at least 40 minutes, because then it'll be a full stream. If not, I'll do something, I guess. So yeah, let's get into it. Now before we start on the Cryon anniversary stream, if you like what you see, make sure to follow the channel and subscribe to the VOD channel. So if you want, you can watch this again when it gets posted there about, like, I guess 20 minutes after stream ends. I don't really know. And screen 3, Jesus. Excuse me. I haven't had a voice crack in a while. Also, Queen's Adventure 3 Across the Cosmos releases this June 6th, 2023. So, be ready for that when it comes out. I'm very excited. I'm stoked. Also, Queen 3. also, Uno Frenzy 2 is happening June 21st. So, be sure to watch that live to see if me or to see if I'm better than Arcade or if Arcade is better than me. I'll probably be better than Arcade. I don't know. So, yeah. Hang on, let me share my screen real quick so you guys can see the window. Yeah. Alright. Uno Frenzy 2 Crash on Mars, indeed. Alright, everyone. I'm on the official Jupitr Entertainment website, which you should go visit. And, yeah, God, I have a lot of games. But yeah. Cryon Inc. June 3rd, 2022. Dang, it doesn't feel like it's been a year. Some days it feels like it was longer. Some days it feels like shorter. It doesn't feel like a year. That's basically what I'm saying. So, yeah, I remember. Hang on. We gotta watch this. Give it a second to load. Alright, their audio is working. Oh, the old Jupitr logo. Oh, God. I remember making this trailer, and I was like, God, this is so cool. If I ever do rewrite or remake or whatever, if I ever do that for Cryon Inc., I'm definitely, like, remaking this trailer, but better. I don't remember when I made this. Well, I remember is like I was proud of this. Oh god, it's gonna jump scare. I didn't take that as a jump scare when I first made it. It was only after I released it that I was like, that startles me sometimes. Oh god, you saw my recommended. So yeah, let's go through the story package just so you can see. So we got thank you messages from me and Arcade. We have some wallpapers, desktop and mobile. Because I'm cool like that. You should announce the bet I lost. The bet you lost? Nah. Well, that'll be a surprise when it comes out. Yeah, I remember. Okay, so funny story. This was always the summary. And then when I was trying to get the book on Google Play, I wanted to add like a little like small little tagline, so I wrote Seven to the Dark Mind of Robert Inkwell as he crowns himself God of this alien city. I wrote that, and then when it didn't work out, I just decided to keep it because like that sounds baller. But yeah, Cryon Inc. story, Big Chungus, or no, Bingus Chingus. That sounds a little racist. I didn't even realize until I said it out loud. Here it is. Actually, I have it. I have the thing on my computer, so why don't I just go through that? That would probably be easy. Story. Boom. Is there anything bad here? No. Okay. So I'm gonna fit it to the screen and then let us do this. Cryon Inc., a Metal Knot story, written narrated by NotTGP. Also, Arcade says I'm racist. I don't condone that. You're on the acknowledgements, so don't say anything bad. Oh, the old Jupitr logo. I like that logo. I forget exactly the reason I remade it. I forget the reason I remade it. But, like, I'm happy with the remake. It looks a lot better. Extremely... Whoa. This is not going to go over well. I can barely talk. He's Zerkanoff. I am Zerkanoff. I have my Zerkoff folder. Or my Zerkoff material, sorry. Acknowledgements. An extremely special thank you to Arcade Gamer for allowing me to write this. And another thank you to all the members of Metal Knot for being such wonderful people. Written by NotTGP. Graphic designed by NotTGP and Arcade Gamer. Metal Knot logo designed by... Oh, I thought this was a Cryon logo for... Or Cryon Inc. logo for some reason. Or that's what registered in my head. Metal Knot logo designed by Arcade Gamer. Cryon Inc. logo designed by NotTGP. Enjoy. Chapters. It probably would have been a little bit more impressive if every page was in a chapter. Let's be real. Beginnings, Metal Bullet Hybrid. Yeah, that's baller. Alright. Chapter 1. You Zerkoff to Cryon. I do Zerkoff to Cryon. Chapter 1. And with the end of the month now finished, Whoa. This is not going to go over well. I'm extremely proud to announce that we were able to raise more than $2 million for the annual food drive. Thank you all. Give me a second. Thank all of you extremely generous souls for donating to help end a crisis in our beloved city. Jeremy Cryon. It had been more than a year since Jeremy's father had passed away, and in his will, he gave Jeremy the money and chance to start his own business. He was able to find one of the tallest skyscrapers in Kishfire for his idea, and he bought it. He arrived at his tower and went to the uppermost floor to start his journey. He looked over the bustling city and sat down in a small folding chair with the previous owners left behind, and began to cry. He thought about everything he did to get to where he was, the sacrifices, the tribulations, and then he thought about how his family was there for him every step of the way. This kind of sucks, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, it doesn't suck, but like, I could probably write it better now. Which, why do you say Kishfire like that? Kissfire? It is not Kissfire. That's wrong, I'm saying Kishfire. Kissfire. Shut up, Arcade. I don't, it's like the person who made a GIF. He said it's pronounced like GIF. I don't respect him. You can name it whatever you want, but we're gonna name it something else. It's Kishfire. He got his head out of his arms and wiped his eyes dry, and he got to work. He began to brainstorm ideas of what he could call his business. He went with Cryon Inc. to honor his family. He started promoting Cryon Inc. to everybody he could. In a few weeks, he had a strong group of workers, and he started the first Cryon food drive, raising $3,000 by the end of the month. People started to take notice of this business. By year's end, he was one of the wealthiest people in Shard, and he let none of that money go to waste, donating what he could every week to various charities in the city, sometimes barely being able to pay the bills for the tower for how much he was giving away. Why is it when I sat up, my voice just went up 2 octaves? Through this, he met Robert Inkwell, a leader in one of the charities the charity Jeremy donated to so heavily. I remember when I was making the audiobook that never came out, I struggled with that line too. Robert admired his giving nature and his enthusiasm. They eventually became good friends. Robert quit his job at Cryon Inc. as co-owner. He never felt power like this. He started to feel like the world was his toy, and he was a mastermind. Robert became power-hungry and wanted the business to stomp on everyone who wronged him. Jeremy began to see it through him and fired him for fear that Robert would do something behind his back. That's a chapter 1.5. Chapter 2, that's where everything goes awry. Chapter 2. At the end of this year, we are proud to announce that since we were able to rid the city of hunger, we will start shifting our focus to helping the scientific community find cures for life-threatening diseases, helping supply hospitals with better funding. Robert became furious once he heard this on TV. He was so close to getting thrown from Jeremy, and he screwed it up. He tried thinking up ways to get back his position. He came with an idea. He would use Jeremy's empathy and get his spot back. I'm bad at reading sentences. And so, yeah, in advance, it's going to be like that for the whole entire reading. He called Jeremy and gave him a half-assed apology. Jeremy began to think he was paranoid for thinking his closest friend would betray him, so he set up a meeting at the tower to give him his role back. Once Robert arrived at the tower, he was greeted with a pen and paper for him to sign on a large wooden table. There was a sticky note with, "Come and see me at the bar once you're all finished up," written on it. He signed the paper and started heading down to the first floor, passing Jeremy's office. He arrived at the bar soon after, seeing Jeremy with an empty seat next to him. He sat down next to him. Jeremy looked Robert in the eyes before, quietly muttering, "Sorry about that, bud." I don't know why I just did Larry accent. Okay, Jeremy is not Larry. Let's get that straight. It's not... I mean, you know what? After Tack left the Metal Knot universe, Larry was reformed into Jeremy. I think. Is that how that works? No, it's not. Or is he? He is. That's actually canon. He was malformed. He was reformed, sure. He paid his tab and walked out of the bar, looking at Robert head for the back exit as the door closed behind him. He slowly walked to his car, but when he attempted to open it, the car sped off into the city. They both use a gun. Catch my drift. No? Jeremy didn't kill himself. Robert killed himself. Oh, sorry. Spoilers. I forgot.
Oopsie poopsie.
Decided that instead of making the situation worse, he would just take the hour walk back to his home. As he wandered the streets of the city, he noticed he was being followed. He couldn't identify the person. They stuck to the shadows and wore an all-black coat. He tried to make numerous twists and turns to get the stalker off his trail. When none of that worked, he decided to stand his ground. The man slowly walked up to him. Jeremy quietly but swiftly pulled out a penknife from his coat pocket. He turned and swung it at the person's leg, however he only grazed it. "Listen, man, I can give you whatever you want," he said, slowly backing up further into the alley. You pathetic. I mean, they both died via gun. Okay, that makes more sense. Yes, they both... Oh, spoilers! God dang it. Stop spoiling it. I know it's been out for a year, but god dang. The stalker just stood there, not saying a word. Jeremy kept backing up. Let's get that straight. Building up his pace until he fully turned around and made a dash. The man pulled a gun and aimed for Jeremy's back. He pulled the trigger. The bullet went right into Jeremy's lower back. He immediately went down to the ground, screaming in pain. Jeremy tried crawling away. The man slowly walked up to his body and stood next to him. He raised the gun once more, putting one round near Jeremy's heart and one in his head. The man stood there, watching Jeremy become surrounded in a pool of his own blood. He began hearing sirens in the distance. He quickly ran away, only slowing down when the sirens were too faint to hear. The man took his gun from his pocket and threw it in a ditch as he walked past. Mystery. I wonder who did it. I'm pretty sure. I mean, you can probably kind of guess, but I'm pretty sure. I mean, I already did ruin it. Because with heavy heart to announce that last night, my good friend Jeremy Cryon was murdered in cold blood. Robert Inkwell. Robert opened the door to his new office. He looked through the glass and saw the city in its hole. The city in its hole? What? Actually, I have an idea. I'm gonna send a message to somebody that I could probably read better than me. Give me a minute. Give me 4 minutes, actually. Okay. So we're gonna get somebody on. Initially, he wasn't gonna be on the stream because he was being a little mean boy before, but you know, I have had a change of heart. Also, considering circumstances, I can't read. All right, state your name, mean boy.
My name's Jerry King from the anime Curse.
My name's Penis. Anyways, Alright, are we gonna do this reading like one page, I do one page?
Sure, man.
Alright. You do chapter 3, I'll do chapter 3.
If you could share your screen, that would be very helpful.
Watch the oh my lord, you were lazy.
Fine, I'll watch.
No,
pull it up on my computer.
Nope. Too late.
It would have been easier to pull it up on my computer, but
it would have been, but you were being a little meanie.
I did nothing, Dad.
You did everything. I'm mad at you.
Okay.
The only reason you're on is because I can't read. So be grateful. Be grateful that I'm dyslexic.
You're treating me like I'm a child who murdered somebody.
Because you did.
No, I haven't done that in a while. So where are we on chapter 3?
Just start from the top. I don't know.
Okay. Now, Chad, I'm professional. It comes with a heavy heart to announce that last night, my good friend Jeremy Cryon was murdered in cold blood. Robert Inkwell. Robert opened the door to his new office. He looked through the glass and saw the city in its whole. He sat down at his desk. He noticed a picture of him and his former friend with his wife.
Voice mod sucks. I tried muting my microphone and it did a little push notification. That's stupid. It ruined everything. Continue.
You need me to go from the beginning again?
Nah, just could go from where you were.
He stared at it before grabbing it and tossing it into the garbage can next to his desk. The glass exploded from the picture frame and hit his hand. Robert pulled his hand back in pain and started to see the damage. He saw the blood in his hand rise out of the wound and drip down onto the table. He marveled at it, wondering how he could stop it permanently. He certainly had an idea. He called up a group of scientists to explain his entire plan. He would start up a company he would name Safe Felt Toys, disguised as a toy manufacturer company that would donate its proceeds. Gosh dang, TGP. You write so complicatedly.
You can do it, Arcade.
That would donate its proceeds to charity and use it as a guard to experiment on human subjects. How could that go bad? When one of the scientists said that his plan was immoral and violated everything they stood for, Robert smiled. He walked up to the man and hit him in the gut, knocking him to the ground. Anybody else wants to stand up for what's right and wrong? He asked. The man groaning in pain, when nobody responded, he started Project Hybrid. He told the group to find a suitable subject and get him something by tomorrow. He walked out of that building knowing he was creating a beast unfit to live. What?
Did you not hear that?
What noise?
There was just like this weird squeak that came out of my mouth.
I didn't hear it, but now I'm laughing thinking about you squeaking.
Sorry about that, Chad. I make some weird
like
mouth
noises.
Like a mouse
over here. He walked into the laboratory. He walked into the laboratory wing and banged on Section 19's door. It was open, and Robert stepped inside without any warning. One of the scientists was trying to explain what they were attempting to do, but all their words flew right through Robert's mind. I had an extra word there, as he saw what he was strapped down on the chair, a gray corpse with chunks of flesh removed from it, its entire skeleton being replaced with scrap metal. And that's the basic rundown. Let's fire them up, shall we? Were the only words that Robert processed before the scientist walked over to the switch. I heard the metal switch hit the fuse box as their monster was being powered on. Its eyelids opened in a snap, and its eyeballs looked around the room. Two other scientists removed the creature's harness and quickly walked away. The creature grabbed onto the armrest and lifted itself up, contacting the floor and standing upright. Its eyes fixated on Robert, and it started walking towards him. Robert backed away slowly as the creature approached him. The scientist flipped another switch and the monster fell to the ground, cold and lifeless, like a bullet case hitting the ground. So do you want to continue this experiment? One of the scientists said, holding a clipboard. I like the plan, but keep that thing the hell away from me, Robert said before quickly leaving the room. You can do it.
No, I can't. That plan is impressive, all things considered. Also, the whole Safe Belt Toys thing, that was just to get a Carmen's Interactive Play Place reference.
Yeah, I was going to say something, but I was too invested.
Robert Inkwell too. He was the guy that owned the place in Kip.
Kip one at least. No, not in Five Nights at Freddy's or canon.
I can't believe this. Why would I do that? Could have done anything else, but no, I just had to put safe belt on. Alright, anyways, chapter 4. I was greeted with two doors, one leading to life and another leading to death. One being on the right, the other being a wrong. Open one of the doors and saw two cold, lifeless eyes staring back at me. I stared into the eyes of a hybrid. I don't know how I came up with that quote, but that quote's fire. Robert,
know what really fire?
These nuts?
Yeah.
You are so predictable. Robert awoke in his office, looking around dazed and confused. He soon remembered falling asleep at his desk. All he could think about was that damn,
say it,
corpse. Say whatever I dang well please. That walked towards him. He decided it would be best to go confront his fears. He walked through the empty, dark hallways of Cryon before finally reaching the laboratory wing. He turned to face the Section 19 door. He gulped and grabbed onto the handle and twisted his wrist, opening the room. All that was there was a spotlight illuminating the hybrid disaster. He walked up to it, telling himself that it could only work when powered. My name's Deez. He knelt in front.
Where did that come from?
No, the robot's name is officially Deez. I don't know why I'm scared of you. Your name's Deez.
Imagine. That better be in Cryon 2.
That is not going to be in Cryon 2. Cryon 2.
I'm not scared of you.
Robert's
going to
hit the nay-nay and revive Jeremy. That's what's going to happen.
I mean, that's probably like his best option. None of that would have happened if you just did the nay-nay.
If I do a Cryon 2, fire me. Flyer me?
I will flyer you.
You will flyer me.
Don't worry.
Dang. He knelt in front of it, not afraid anymore. I don't even know why I thought of the idea for you. You're just a rotten corpse full of thrown out metal. Robert heard a pop from a television next to him, the screen turning on and illuminating the dark room. He shifted his head over to it. However, all that was on the screen were the words, quoth the raven, nevermore. Robert looked back in the creature. Please stop masturbating, I'm trying to read.
Clap, you dungweed!
Robert looked back and the creature's head was upright, its eyes piercing into Robert's soul. Its eyes followed him, never blinking. Robert was frozen in shock. He stood up and pulled out his pistol from his side pocket and shot the corpse in the head. He went limp onto the chair before letting out a whining noise before it ceased all noises. Robert was well shaken. He ran out of the building as fast as he could and ran home.
There's the quote. Alright.
He turned to the screen and all that was on there was quote, my name's Deez. That would be fire. That's gonna be Cryon 3. Alright, go.
Cryon 4, get it right. Cryon 3 is about Jeremy's drug addiction.
Sorry, I forgot. Alright, chapter 5, love you.
This morning we went into the room and
Capacitor.
You are using non-existent language.
This is literally a term.
That is moon runes.
That is not moon runes.
This morning we went into the room and the capacitor must have been blown in project. Hit its head.
H17.
What? H17. Oh, it looked like hit. Okay. A capacitor must have blown in project. Hits H17's head. They set us back a bit, so we're very sorry. Adam Rose, Section 19. Robert balled up the sticky note and threw it in the garbage. He couldn't stop thinking about the encounter that happened that night before. He wanted to see just how capable those monsters were. He decided to write a note telling Section 19 to put trackers on the next few instances and release them into the national park. In the coming days, a few of the hybrids were thrown out into the wild, outfitted with cameras to track their positions. Robert would stare at the cameras all day, seeing how their minds worked. After a week, all were captured by Cryon and returned to one of the facilities. That is all but one. They tried to desperately. Maybe I'm just this last like.
You can't even get out
Maybe
the
I'm
word.
Stupid.
We're both stupid.
They tried desperately to get to this. We tried desperately to get to the instance before anyone in the city found it. However, it was found by public. By the public. When law enforcement arrived, they quickly put a bullet in it, putting it down instantly. The trackers hastily thrown onto them were branded with the Cryon Ink logo. In a matter of hours, a mob of nearly half the city was on the skyscraper's doorstep, demanding Robert come out and explain the monster they found. I'm sure Michael was happy about that. Robert stood looking down at the crowd. He did not say these nuts while looking at the crowd.
He did.
It's canon. Like, okay, I know you've been wanting an answer. These nuts. He just walks out.
The SpongeBob meme. These nuts. And then Mr. Krabs throws the guy out of the restaurant. Krusty Krab. Why is there a man made out of a robot? These nuts.
And everyone claps.
Also, can I just say, if you're going to put trackers on your weird, like, monster thing, why would you put the Cryon
logo?
Logo,
yeah.
That's the stupidest thing ever.
Like, if I was going to say something about future, but I can't spoil that yet. That's for the next thing.
Future has sex.
Listen, Amy Tyra did not build up her empire of sex havers just for you to say it sucks.
Amy had sex with the building. That's why it's cursed. Or something. I don't know.
Curse. Anime curse.
Season 4.
Coming soon! Summer 2023, baby.
Anyways, finish the last paragraph.
Yeah, I was going. Robert's still looking down at the crowd below. He knew that if he didn't.
Oh!
I thought about the deep nuts and tried to hold it back.
Oh, I thought that was a voice crack and a half. I heard I saw the exact moment when the joke hit your head.
He knew that if he didn't do something, they would have him and his team heads on pikes. He thought for a second. He realized that no matter what he did, the entire world would condemn him. He knew he had to impose drastic measures, so he hit a button located on the side of his desk. He waited for a second before a loud bang erupted from the building as sheets of metal covered the doors, sealing them airtight. The metal covered every window in the skyscraper except for the ones inside Robert's office. There was a total lockdown of the building and nobody in and nobody out. Robert had already planned for this, storing tons of food and water in his vaults. This was now home for the hundreds of people that worked there. Why did they just kill him there and then with the monsters they created?
I don't know.
Aw, dang it,
Weird, like, that. He had some weird precognition, like, oh, yes, the city's going to be mad at me. I must construct this. I mean, he had good plans. He was good at planning. Also, wait, I just realized, why you made these, like, weird monsters, like, yes, send them out into the parks. That's a good place.
Why would you send it out to Butler Fields? Actual place of Chicago, by the way.
Oh yeah, I forgot. That is a legit place in Chicago.
And Chicago is, guess what?
Gay.
Very. So all right. Said his name was Deez when like Roblox were invaded or something. It was very weird.
Chapter 6. I can fix this city. James Butler. James Butthole.
Ooh. Oh my god. I have to change his name.
Sorry. I ruined it.
Mr. Butthole.
Mr. Butthole.
Mr. Alva coming up to Mr. Butler. There's like Butler. He says, Mr. Butthole. I mean, Butler, I need your help.
Mr. Hole.
What is this? Is his first name Butt, last name Hole?
His full name is James. His middle name is Butt, and his last name is Hole. Mr. Hole? Well, call me James. Mr. Hole is my father's name.
And you didn't even want me on the stream. Do you know how less funny butt jokes there'd be if you didn't allow me on here?
Mr. Hole. Mr. Butt. Hole. Robert hid in his office for weeks. Oh my god. Mr. I always said Mr. Hole hid in his office. Robert hid in his office for weeks, waiting for the crowds to calm and his workers to accept the reality that they were stuck in here. He watched the city. Slowly, the mob stopped showing up and eventually stopped turning up altogether. Robert turned to push the button to unseal the facility. However, he paused. He thought that with the skyscraper sealed off away from the world, he would be able to rule it like a country. He pulled his hand away from the button, deciding that he would rule the people inside his building.
What was that?
I was trying to get down all the liquids in my throat.
Uh-huh.
Semen. He sat down with his head in his hands, figuring out what his next move would be. Suddenly, the power cut and his room went dark. He couldn't see an inch in front of him. He moved away from his desk, looking around. I thought that was a comma. I'm stupid. The power turned back on. He heard a loud boom. He quickly pushed the button to open the shutters. When they opened, he saw the city up in flames. Embers billowed from nearly every building as the sky turned black as night. Sirens fired off rapidly in the distance as buildings collapsed on top of themselves. The ash fogged up Robert's windows, leaving him blind to everything that happened. More explosions fueled the city as hundreds of people screamed. Just as fast as it happened, the city fell silent. This is the work of Mr. Butthole.
Imagine, Robert, this is the work of
Mr. Butthole. Damn you, Mr. Butthole!
Imagine!
I will have my revenge! Like, he's shaking his fist up in the sky. Damn you, Mr. Butthole. This is not what I thought this stream would be.
This is serious! We have to be serious!
We're not even halfway through the book and it's already been 30 minutes. The ash cleared up from Robert's windows and he looked upon a fallen empire. The city was darkened. God dang it, train! This is sad.
I don't hear it.
I hear it. Hang on.
Very thirsty. Mind if I give me something to drink real quick?
Yeah, go get some butthole juice.
I'm gonna get the butthole juice.
The butthole juice. I don't know if he wants me to continue, so whilst we wait, if you haven't heard already, which if you should have, because I mentioned it at the beginning of the stream, but Squeen's Adventure 3 Across the Cosmos releases this June 6, 2023, so make sure to go download that when it comes out. Is he back? Oh, he's back. I heard him sit down. Oh. Yeah. I hear him.
Hello?
There he is.
I thought you were still reading. I wasn't trying to interrupt.
The ash cleared from Robert's windows as he looked upon a fallen empire. The city was darkened by the concrete and wood that lay on the roads. Robert took in the dark reality that everything he loved in this world was gone in the span of a minute. The ground began to shake. Robert fell to the ground as the sky became a bright, blinding white. A red gash opened up from the sky as a red mist poured under the city. The air became dark as a crimson fog laid itself onto the city. The collapsed buildings started rebuilding themselves, almost like they were going back in time before they were burned. When the dust settled, everything was put back together. However, the city was a harsh red and black. There was seemingly no life left in the city. Robert checked the security cameras and everyone was accounted for, all equally scared and confused. Robert looked outside again. With nobody left in the streets, he'd won. He'd be able to take the city under his control, and nobody could stop him. His head cleared the dark thoughts already in his head, and ideas flooded him. He owned the economy, the infrastructure, and the people. His first plan of action was to have control of everybody left in the city.
That darn Mr. Butthole. He did this. Thank you, Mr. Butthole.
Yeah, it was actually, Mr. Butthole didn't wave, ow, I hit the mic. Mr. Butthole didn't wave his hand across the city. He waved his penis, and I'm pretty sure. Wait, isn't it canon that James cut his hand on the Cryon building?
I guess.
That's even cooler.
That's why it shook.
I'm gay. Anyways, continue.
Okay, before we go on, so, when did ever in the story announce he had cameras checking on everyone?
It's a big building. I just assumed that would be, like,
I meant, like, people inside the building. Okay, okay.
He installed cameras in every home, in every bathroom. He could stare at everybody's penis.
Oh, he was just there for the penis. So Robert's canonically gay.
He is worth like billions of dollars. So I mean.
Okay, so my guess by this point, Mr. Butthole's son is gone.
Maybe. He waved his hand. He waved his hand. So if he's gone before that, then yeah.
Huh. Okay. I'm just not thinking about that.
Anyways, chapter 7. Hit it, Fergie.
What'd you call me? Fruity?
No, I called you Fergie. Never mind. It's a song.
Kermie?
Just read the chapter.
You okay, goober. Me, Mr. Fergie, is going to read chapter 7. Unstoppable. Indestructible. I am a god. Robert Inkwell.
I am these nuts. I am these. Robert's middle name is D's, confirmed.
Robert D's Inkwell. Wait!
Sheriff.
Robert D's Inkwell.
D's Inkwells.
Who's Inkwell?
D's.
Why is he D'ing him?
Read the chapter.
Why is Robert D'ing Inkwell? Okay. He immediately started working. He started thinking of how to control the remaining population. Robert heard of a rumor that one of his competitors, Future,
Future,
was experimenting with humans. Future, speaking of Future, he could create a weapon to control the entire city. He set up a meeting with an official for a collaboration. Once the door was shut in the meeting room, he pulled a knife from his pocket and began to stab multiple times. His body hit the ground, dead. He grabbed the folder out of the desk and left. Once he arrived back at the tower, he slammed the folder on the table, telling the team of scientists sitting there, "Unless you want to die in here, get to work and do whatever you need to make this work." Robert began walking back to his office. One of them opened the folder and began looking through the pages. A tear hit the page as he realized he was a slave to a madman. God, this is amazing writing, dude. Holy. It's immaculate.
Project D's.
Oh my god. I'm trying to compliment you, and you're making these nuts and Mr. Butt jokes. I'd appreciate it if you would.
To be fair, I'd spent like 2 months on this chapter alone.
They all headed back to their lab and began to sort through the pages, seeing all the people that were trapped there with no hope of escape. People with families, people that deserved everything better than being forced to watch a TV screen for hours on end. Flip through the pages upon.
You can tell this chapter was written before Tack was taken out. That was supposed to be a little Tack reference. Oopsie poopsie.
Ooh. I get it now. They flipped through the pages upon pages of research, trying to find the right person with the right set of tests and experimentation. "Hey, take a look at this one," one of them said, throwing down a piece of paper. "Kid talks about seeing some blue figure with no arms." Uh-oh.
Oopsie poopsie. I forgot to take that out. And it's unrelated. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, it's a different guy with...
Different ghost Larry. With blue Larry. With no arms.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Yeah. That's his cousin, Terry.
Terry was already supposed to be a thing.
Yeah, exactly. Boom. Works perfectly.
No.
"Are they pumping anything into his room?" Another one of the scientists interjected. Interjaculated. Nope. We had the same idea.
"Are they pumping anything into his room? Come."
Imagine Amy just sitting in her room. Sitting in a room like, huh.
Pump double the semen in that room.
yes.
Governance by 12.
Activate the cum suffocate. Chambers. Why is she British?
Activate the cum gas.
The cum gas. That's what I spit out. Wait a minute, hang on. Not like spit, but never mind. Read it.
We talking about spit? This is not what Limoy wanted.
This is not this is not what Jeremy lived for.
Robert did not kill Robert. Jeremy just to be.
No, wait, you don't. Amy we don't Tyler know Robert killed not. Jeremy yet. We're not at that part of the story yet. We're not at that part of the story yet.
I'm joking. I'm talking about Cryon too.
He was trolling.
You're trolling. Just a bit of goofing, you know.
A little bit of guffaws.
No, pretty sure you're just going insane from the stuff they're doing to him. Like the vine boom sound effect. He threw that piece of paper into a nearby garbage can and started looking through the pages again. Found something, one of them said. She pulled out. Oh, wait, that's just me, a girl.
You know what? Kishfire or Cryon is very progressive.
It is June.
It's June. Also, what was that? Did you just shoot your monitor? It is June. You got like 2 senses. Come on. Ow! I poked myself in the eye.
Alright. She pulled out 2 pages from the folder. One for what human tissue does to certain chemicals, and one how to create airborne hallucinogens.
Woo! Yeah! Chapter 8, baby! Carl,
Mr. Beast?
Oh, Ryan! Cryon! Oh, Robert! We can't make this! Oh, Robert, what are you doing? Locking us up in this room!
Mr. Beast! It was foretold!
Carl, Mr. Beast. Oh, hey, Robert, you're going mad with power! Oh, Jeremy, I love working under you.
That's not a good idea! You should stop!
Can you say croissant in that voice? Croissant?
Oh,
it sounds like the dude from Jimmy Neutron. What was his name?
Carl?
Oh my god, there's no way!
Oh, Jimmy!
The three Carls! What's Carl Rose, what's Carl what's Jimmy, Carl Jimmy Neutron, Carl Mr. Beast, Carl Jimmy Beast.
Carl Cheeseburger.
Anyways. Whatever it takes to get out of this hell safely. Carl Rose, Section 33, Head Scientist of Project Rainfall.
Dude, you should have said it with the Carl Beast voice.
Whatever it takes to get out of this hell safely. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. They went onto the city streets looking for a suitable lab rat when they happened upon a small girl. They approached... They approached her, and she said that she got lost after picking up a purple rock and was looking for her parents. A meth moment. The scientists looked at each other, knowing they found the perfect person. They took her back to the tower, promising they would help her find her parents. Once they were inside, one of the scientists took a spare lead pipe. You have that hanging around. From a cabinet. Hitting her in the back of the head with the pipe, knocking her out cold. They dragged her body to a
table.
He didn't
even say what he said, you dungweed.
Well, too far. There. They dragged Bonnie. Harvesting whatever they could. Once she was used up, they threw her lifeless body behind the tower and shut the doors. Her eyes opened. She looked at the red-black sky above her. She couldn't move. She felt a deep, guttural pain within herself. She tried to breathe, but she couldn't. She kept her eyes to the clouds as a tear went down her face, knowing she was dying. Her vision began to fade, and she felt relief as she passed away to another world. They just killed the kid. What the hell?
Wait, hold on. Is this supposed to be, you know, Amber?
It's whoever you dang well want it to be.
Because I know Amber dies from, you know, Cryon.
Then it's the whole reason. Then yeah, it's Amber.
That's why Avar went mad. Spoilers.
Then yeah, it's Amber. Rest in peace. Rest in penis. Anyways.
But, okay, then my question is... That puts some loopholes in my story.
It's just some random girl they found and they killed for some reason.
But is this what causes the rain?
We'll get to that. Back in the lab... Shush! Back in the lab, the scientists were able to create a chemical that simulated sleep paralysis while the victim was still awake, making them see some of their deepest fears. They all started crying, knowing they were one step closer to finally seeing the people they loved. Hey, Arcade, I'm going to pee my pants. So if you could take over for a page or two.
Okay, where'd you left off at?
I guess just start the second paragraph. I'll be right back. Sorry.
Okay, chat. It's my turn now. My turn to let future rule. Attack reference. Attack. All right, let's read this. Back in the lab, the scientists were able to create a chemical that simulated sleep paralysis while the victim was still awake, making them see some of the darkest fears. They all started crying, knowing they were one step closer to finally seeing the people they loved. One of them started transporting a beaker full of the substance across the room into a small refrigerator. As he set it down, the liquid splashed up, hitting his skin. His vision became tunneled as he hit the floor paralyzed. He started seeing some of his darkest fears come to life. He saw his wife and kid viciously tortured, crying out in pain and agony. He couldn't take it anymore. He looked around and put his fist through the glass door of a cabinet. The glass shattered into a giant, sharp chunk. He grabbed one of the shards and dug it into his own head, killing him. The rest of the scientists looked around at each other, shocked. They started realizing how much of a weapon they had on their hands. Chapter 9. I just want to go home. Fudge. Screw me. Chapter 9. We're doing this again. That didn't count. Chapter 9. I just want to go back home.
Butthole.
Carl Rose. Okay.
Sorry. I'm back.
It's my page now anyway, so.
Dang. That's crazy.
If you want to do Carl... Also, it's
I
so
just
want sad.
To go back home, Jimmy. We've been doing the Squid Game Challenge for too long.
Jimmy, my jaw hurts.
Jimmy, I just saw my wife and kids being tortured.
Can I go home, Jimmy?
Jimmy.
Now, Carl, what did I tell you about complaining? Jimmy, I'm sorry, Jimmy.
We gave 100 people the Cryon Jungle Juice. Whoever lives gets $10,000. Oh, Jimmy, this seems really bad. We should be doing this.
It just snaps his neck. They takes a bottle and just pours it all over him like a shower.
to participate in the challenge, I will be drinking this entire bottle. Tastes like... Okay, canonically, it tastes like grape. Which, that is a punishment. It's a punishment before the punishment. Our kid went silent. I don't think he liked that comment. Okay.
I wasn't even paying attention, in all honesty.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Chapter 9. I just want to go back home, Jimmy! Carl Rose, Section 33. Former head scientist of Project Rainfall. Ooh, I like that name. What?
His name
wow,
is Deez.
My brain just shut off. I've been watching too much anime. Anyway. They knew all...
You can do it. I believe in you.
They knew that all they had to do was figure out a way to spread this easily, and they were homebound. They soon thought of a Project Rainfall, harnessing the never-ending rain to their advantage by pushing the chemical into the clouds so that anyone caught in their rain would be doomed to see their worst nightmares. They told Robert about this, and he gathered them all into the lab, congratulating them. Does this mean we get to go home now? One of the scientists asked. Robert smiled to himself, silently giggling. One way or another, you'll have to start finding out that the real life isn't what you make of it. He nudged his way out of the doorway, the metal slamming together with a loud bang, trapping them in the lab. They all started banging on the door, pleading to be let out. Robert gave the sounds of a cold, lifeless... Gave the sounds of a cold, lifeless stare. I kind of get it, you know.
Oopsie,
sounds
oopsie.
Banging, they're banging.
Oh yeah, he gave the banging a cold, lifeless stare.
Okay.
He didn't give the sounds of a cold, lifeless. He didn't give the stare. He didn't give the sounds of what would happen if he gave a cold, lifeless stare.
Okay.
I'm not good at writing.
I just lost my place. Robert gave the sound of cold, lifeless stare as he walked away. Robert took the vial with the substance in it to the roof of the tower. Cryon had designed a confetti launcher to fire confetti into the sky whenever one of his charity goals were reached. Even after your death, you're still useful to me, Robert said to himself. Robert ran over to the launcher. He loaded the vial and fired the cannon. His ears rang as the blast sent the liquid into the sky. He waited for a sign that his experiment worked. Just then, a dark blue wave shot itself across the skyline, infecting the other clouds like a cancer. Robert quickly headed off the roof, wanting to see his pawns fall into place.
Hey!
Woo! I like that! That's good.
I had to do it. He forced me.
I did force him. That's true, Chad.
I don't think you did. I think I did that out of the kindness of my own heart. My name's Deez. Anyways.
Alright. He stood staring at the city below in his office, watching the few people that were walking around freely in the city intently. He stared at them as he saw a few of them stop. Then, just like ants, they started falling to the ground. They writhed. That's a word I've never heard before. As Robert smiled at his achievement, he watched as some of... I thought it's all penis.
I thought I did too. I thought I was crazy. It's pens. It's pens. I thought it was penis too. I'm not even gonna lie. I saw it at the same exact time. That's weird. I was like, wait a minute. Does that say peens? Penis. I can't speak. Anyways, continue.
Okay. He stared at them as he saw a few of them stop, and just like ants, they started falling to the ground. They writhed as Robert smiled at his achievement. He watched some of them hit their heads on buildings, off the sidewalk, and some even took pens from their pockets and stabbed themselves. He began laughing. Kissfire was now his city to control. It was at his bidding now. Robert immediately started calling for more apartments to make more of the substance, and telling them what it did. Once they made it, they were executed with it. The people that were killed with it were used to make more of it, restarting the vicious cycle.
The vicious cycle of these nuts. Anyways, we're almost there. We only got like 4.5 chapters.
Let's go.
Chapter 10.
How long are we in the stream?
An
hour.
54 minutes.
And we're not even halfway through what you have planned.
We're way past halfway through it. What are you talking about?
You don't have that much in the thing?
Oh, I thought you meant in the story. No, I have like 49 sides. It's a lot. There's a lot of history of Cryon. We'll get there, though.
History of
Cryon. As long as we all work together, we'll all be able to go home sooner. Robert Inkwell. The night sky rumbled as the dark blue rain hit the concrete roads. It had been a year since rainfall had started being pumped into clouds. The once alive streets were now a barren wasteland, as everybody needed to stay inside their houses to avoid the rain. Dead bodies piled up in the streets. Only a few could be pulled into the tower at a time to avoid suspicion. However, as the days passed, the bodies became less and less. Robert stared out at the city from the uppermost floors, having to devise a plan. Just as he started to think, his phone began ringing. He walked away from the glass and put the phone on speaker. Robert speaking, he said in an officious tone. That's a word and a half.
That and a half is a full-on word, gamer! You didn't cut it! Everyone go quiet. Wow, I heard a cat. Uh-oh, TGP is dead. We killed him. It's so sad, chat. Can we get an F in chat? TGP?
Mad gamer. What'd I miss?
Did he even say, I'll be right back?
Sorry. My cat started, I started jumping out of the window. I had to catch it real quick.
Like Spider-Man?
Yeah.
Oh, save you!
Sorry. There was a school bus full of handicapped children that I had to save. I had to go do that real quick. Where was I? Hey, Mr. Inkwell, the voice on the other end responded. This is Adam Rose of Section 19. That's Carl Rose's brother. Small world. We were able to get H-119 fully up and running. Robert's heart felt like a drop to the ground floor once he recognized the name. We'd all appreciate it if you were to drop by. Robert ended the call, not responding to the request. He turned around and looked back at the Kitch Fire. I'm not good with spelling. One part of him wanted to see the advancement of the hybrid, while the other didn't know if he could take the mental turmoil. He looked up, staring at his own eyes through the reflection in the window. You can't live without fear, he told himself. He stood his body straight, fixed his tie, walked out of the doors of the office. Robert slowly walked down the hallways of the tower, feeling fear surrounding his soul. He knew nothing would happen. However, his mind kept reminding him of the hybrid's cold, dead eyes. He finally reached the door. A bold yellow stripe, reading Section 19, Research and Testing. He slowly pulled his hand up onto the door handle. He could feel his heart beating 1,000 times a second. He took a long, deep breath and pushed the handle down. The metal rods pulled themselves out of the wall, and the door began opening.
DGP, what happened? Hello?
Hello?
Did you die?
No, I read the entire chapter.
Dang, my mind is not... I'm so sorry. I'm thinking about Chainsaw Man.
You're too high. You gotta stop snorting that loud.
I'm high on that Mountain Dew.
You gotta stop snorting weed. Anyways, chapter 11. That's your chapter.
Okay. What?
It's your chapter to read.
Oh, I thought it's like your chapter. Like, oh, am I in this?
I made this specially for you. You are canon. That is official.
I looked down at the endless stairwell, seeing the shadow of a contorted being displayed on the wall. The closer I approached, the more I realized it was far from alive. Unknown. Man, this guy sounds great.
Who doesn't name their kid? What an idiot. Who names their kid Unknown? That joke sucks.
Yeah, that's how I'm not laughing.
Dang. That's rude.
Bloody Land, that was the laboratory.
Are you British?
The Bloody Land in the laboratory broke Robert's eyes.
Robert took Robert took a sea of his tip and teep. Of his teed crumpets before he shot himself in the face. I took a solid 5 minutes to get that joke out.
The Bloody Knot of the Libertarian burnt Robert's eyes! Great underage stuff.
Anyways.
The blinding light of the
He did it again.
Dang it! the blinding light of the Libertarian.
Go slowly.
The blinding light of the laboratory pierced Robert's eyes as the door slowly opened. His eyes adjusted to the light. I don't know why I must start.
His eyes adjusted to these nuts. Start laughing. I'm paying you to be here.
How much?
12 cents an hour.
Oh, his eyes. Oh my god.
You're not gonna be paid if you keep speaking like that.
Sorry, Dad.
You will be.
His eyes adjusted to the light. He walked into the room, observing all the medical equipment laid onto the various tables. What are the tables? Sorry, I'm thinking about British people.
What? No, British people were not laid out onto the various tables. There was medical equipment.
Where was it?
No, I think it was medical equipment. They did not lay British people out into the tables.
Oh, what you bloody doing to me, Robert? You bloody... What you about to my weed, mate?
You are a strange little man. I hope you know that.
Welcome to ADHD life, my friend. One of the tables had a small IV bag resting on top of it with a transparent liquid flowing through it, too. Uh-oh. Not the same thing.
I thought it before you even started the sentence. I looked at it, I was like, come.
We need to take that and, like, put it onto, like, a soundboard.
Come.
I'm just gonna play that during Arcadia.
I can just say that during Arcadia.
Say it when, like, finds something weird, like, come.
Okay. Alright. Anyways.
Following the tube with his eyes, it flowed into a large metal box. The metal knot.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Are you ready to see history, Mr. Inkwell? One scientist asked. Told you there were British people on that table.
No. You didn't say that on the table. You just taking a quick nap.
I thought it was Inkwell. I'm taking a quick nap in the 80s.
You ready to see history, Mr. Inkwell? He says, sitting up from the table. What? Anyways, continue.
What's that? Robert gulped. Gulp.
Come.
I don't know why I physically gulped.
Okay. Oh. Why am I so good at making mouth noises?
Because you're gay!
That's true.
Robert gulped and peered at the box, horrified at what would be shown. His mind crumbled before he realized something. He was these people's gods. This is like Arcadia. They were all completely dependent on him. He could bend them to his will. Whoa!
Hey, yo!
Cryon, man, that's sexual assault.
I mean, he's the ruler of Kishfire right now, so he could do whatever he dang well pleases.
Do you think he would cleep? Cleep?
Cleep?
Do you think him and Amy, you know...
Are you asking me if they would have sex? I don't know.
Yes.
Would they?
Do you think?
I don't know. No.
Listen, this is where the fanfic writers in the future, all right? We're giving them material, all right?
I'm not.
One day we're going to see Robert X Amy Lemon on Wattpad or something. Robert seductively looked into her eyes and said,
"Oh God, no! I already wrote no."
Why, Sherry?
Start reading.
I'm sorry.
I have a horrible image in my head now, and I don't like it.
My friend is watching the stream, but she just texted me.
Robert already looks like Mr. House from New Vegas, so I don't like. I already know what one of the parties looks like. It looks like Mr. House from...
Imagine.
Oh, you're such a strange little boy.
He could bend them to his will. He could choose what he was exposed to. He could write his own life. Actually, tell you all what, he said, reaching into his pocket and pulling out a folded out piece of paper with the ingredients of rainfall written down on it. If you can all figure out how I'd be able to get this into every home, I'll make sure you're all the first ones out when the rain ends. Let the sun rise. One of the scientists looked at the piece of paper, gazing their eyes down it.
Gay?
We'd probably be able...
It's June. Release a gayified version of Cryon.
I'm going to stab you.
Shut up. Read it.
Okay.
Please.
I forgot where I was at.
Figure out.
Gazing their eyes down it. We'd probably be able to make this into a gas and get into the sewer system. Robert smiled. They would be driving the entire city to death without even knowing. All right, start working, he said, and that winged another word out of the team. Wait, Mr. Inkwell, what about 9/11?
He did not make 9/11. That is not canon.
That's my next project, said Robert.
My father did that. No, wait a minute.
My father was Mr. 9/11 himself.
Okay, so let's get this family tree straight. Osama bin Laden, Robert Inkwell, amazing.
Hey, Amire? Princess, stuff going on here.
What the hell?
Okay, wait. Hey, Brinko, what about H19? Robert turns slowly. I think the agent just says hentai, and it's like... Hentai 19, Robert turns slowly, making his eyes towards the IV bag. Fill it. Wait, the transparent liquid.
The cum! He slammed his fist into the cum. He looked at the cum. He just went silent. I'm pretty sure he's laughing.
Wait, Mr. Inkle, what about H19? Robert turned slowly, moving his eyes toward the IV bag. He saw when he walked in. Robert slowly walked up to it and slammed his fist down on it, making the bag pop and leak onto the table.
There's cum on the table.
This is higher priority. This is higher priority. He said before walking out of the laboratory. That punch!
The laboratory! Just screw it. Just say laboratory at this point. We're an hour in.
The laboratory and shutting the door. He ran back into the office and he now had a plan. He picked up his phone and called for the two things. Remote
Hello,
explosives
Mr.
that would blow. Hello, Mr. Joe Biden.
Hello, Jill Biden. It's too big of a job for Joe. Joe Biden on the line. This is too big of a job for Joe. We have to get Joe Biden on the line.
He picked up his phone.
Stop thinking about Joe Biden!
Mr. Beast and Mr. Beast! They were in the teaser, alright?
Oh yeah, I forgot. The Cryon anniversary, there was Mr. Beast and Jimmy Beast.
Mr. Jerk off himself.
Shut up. Get out of my head. You are such a goober.
Okay. He picked up his phone.
He gets something about Joe Biden. Hey, I'll finish this off so you can just keep laughing.
No, I gotta do it.
Okay.
Think about Chainsaw Man and big anime party. He picked up his phone.
He picked up his phone and called for two things.
He picked up his phone and called for two things. Remote explosives that would blow up the vials and a team to bring the gas into the main sewer system. Now all he had to do was wait for the pawns to fall. Hey, after a week of waiting, he opened the door up to his office and found a brown cardboard.
delivered personally by Joe Biden herself.
Herself, huh? Congrats on the translation. He opened the door to his office and found a brown cardboard box and he could drop his desk.
Why is it so funny?
Funny three. Finding three vials
filled with red gas and cum.
Finding three vials filled with red gas and explosives. He called up a team of three people and told him the plan.
Joe Biden, and Mr. Beast.
Joe Biden, Carl Beast, and Mr. Beast.
Carl Beast. It's Carl Jacobs, actually. Jimmy Beast.
He opened the door to his office, finding three bottles filled with red gas and explosives. He called up a team of three people and told them the plan. He began telling the team that the gas would give the people immunity to the rain, and that it was the only option. They accepted it and traveled down the elevator with them. escorting them to the front entrance. Boom, did it.
The Carl, hello, is this Jimmy Beast? Hello, is this Joe Biden? The Carl Grochies gave me diarrhea. Please sue them. Hello, Joe Biden. You're a doctor, right? The Carl Mr. Beast burger gave me diarrhea. Hello, Joe Biden. This is Carl, Mr. Beast.
Himself.
Chapter 12. I'm not reading that subtext because that's a little bit problematic.
What? How?
Don't worry about me. The team geared up in hazmat suits and stood in front of the entrance. Robert's standing behind them. The doors opened slowly as the smell of ash flooded the office of Cryon. The red fog began slowly seeping into the building as the team carefully carried the cardboard box into the city. Once the team was outside, the doors were sealed and the fog that carried itself into the tower began to dissipate.
Joe Biden appeared from the fog.
Joe Biden is the fog, bro.
The fog is coming.
Robert traveled up to his office and waited.
So am I.
Waiting for a call that would signal his victory. After what felt like an eternity, his phone began ringing. Robert picked up the phone hastily. Is the package in place? He asked, not giving the other person on the end of the line time to talk. Yes, Mr. Inkwell, it's ready, the man said, stuttering. Robert could barely compose a smile. He hung up the phone and retrieved the detonator from his office, from his desk drawer. How did I turn that into office?
My
mind's like autocorrect. It just fills in what it thinks it's there, and it's not there at all. Robert looked out onto the city. He felt excitement race through his veins. He armed the bomb and took in the city he would be god of. First comes the rainfall, he said, putting his thumb over the button to detonate the bomb. Then the hellfire, he finished. He pushed the button down and waited to hear the explosions. A few moments passed and nothing happened. He pushed it repeatedly, trying to get it to work. God dang it. I don't know why I'm imagining him saying it exactly like that.
Mr. Baha!
Yeah, dang it. He yelled, throwing the detonator at the window and cracking it. He tried to hold in his anger and calm himself, but he began to notice the sound of the rain hitting his window that he was so used to eventually beginning to fade. The everlasting rain eventually became less and less until eventually it ceased. There are a lot of big words that even I don't understand in this. Robert was floored. He began wondering if it was he who had caused the rain to end. He saw people come out of their homes, happy that the rain finally stopped. Robert became enraged. His only control over the city was gone, and he was now merely a rich figure in a blood-soaked tower. However, just as his anger began, he heard the sound of thunder barrel down from the heavens. He looked up and saw the clouds begin to part as something stared down at the tower. It was humanoid, but the size of it proved to be too vast and cosmic. It formed itself over the city like a god looking down on the creation. The immeasurable being raised its arm up and pointed directly towards Robert. A booming voice. Oh, God, I'm itching my nutsack. That feels so good.
We are live on stream!
I'm aware. And?
You do not...
The man who imprisoned you, it said. It stayed unmoving as skyline. It stayed unmoving as skyline as it spoke. Oh, I'm confusing two different things. It stayed unmoving as everybody talked amongst themselves, wondering what Robert did. Rain turned blue's infinity as created a toxic omnicide. It spoke once more. People began realizing what the entity was trying to tell them. It was Robert who made the poison to the skin. Poison to these nuts. Anyways, chapter 13.
Oh, you're finished? Oh, God. Oh, okay.
Kiss my penis.
It is June. Can I say no homo in June?
No, it's physically impossible.
Dang it. What about if I have socks on?
Maybe.
Okay, that's a...
Too big of a risk? Okay.
They dare turn against a god, Robert Inkwell, 2023.
These nuts.
After his penis got chopped.
After his penis. The penis below.
The penis fumbled down into the city. Landing on someone's head.
What are you even saying?
I don't know.
You're a stranger, little boy.
Okay. The people below gather themselves into a legion. And march straight? Straight?
In June!
And then it march gay for the tower. Gay for the tower!
You are a goober.
What? That sounded so muffled, low quality. I can't tell if that was you or a sound clip.
Listen, I was stretching. Okay, I was stretching. And I felt the need to do that. Finish the goddamn story.
Okay.
Finish these nuts.
And march straight to the tower. Robert watched from below. They swarmed the streets like flies, headed straight to their target. The Leviathan pointed everyone towards the man who tried to rule the city in the cover of shadow. Robert marched towards the entrance at two. Oh, wow, we're almost at the end of the notice. Robert walked towards the entrance to his office and hit a button next to it. The door sealed it airtight as people broke through the tower doors. Robert planted himself down in his chair. He was bunkered down in his office. Within minutes, the Legion took the tower over, surrounding every room, having nearly every scientist join them once. They found out what was happening outside. Robert had to think quickly. He tried to press a button to steal the facility. However, it didn't work. The Legion members who got into the tower quickly learned where Robert's office was. They stood outside it. They banged hard.
They banged? On the door. They banged the door? Kids, if you take anything away from the stream, don't bang doors.
Actually, if you use protection, and if they're legal age, don't bang an a minor.
A door that's not legal age.
It has to be 18 years or older. In door years.
Door years. What's a door year?
Like an hour equals 2 minutes. So
that anyway. Helps me no way. Robert jolted slightly, like a fourth line from the bottom.
Oh, they banged hard on the door. Robert jolted slightly. Robert, you better open up the door. We'll open it for you, one of them yelled. Robert didn't respond, hoping they would all go away. The monster began to fade away into the clouds, but the damage was already done. Robert could hear the members talking amongst themselves as the crowd raged below. We're rigging this tower to blow to hell and back! Now get us out here! Robert tried to convince himself that he would escape out of this unharmed. However, that hope dwindled by the minute. They talked to each other once more. You asked for it! We're coming in! Robert tried to think of a way out to ward them off. However, the only ideas he could conjure were him not making it out alive. A giant bulge at the door made Robert finally turn. A giant blow to the door made Robert finally turn to face the door. You people won't be able to bring someone down someone like me, Robert yelled over the mob, 100 stories down. There was another bang of the door, not responding to him. You dare threaten my tower? How do I know you're not bluffing?
You shouldn't have said that. You shouldn't have said that.
What does he mean, how do I know?
Yeah.
What? Anyway, the banging of the door stopped. Robert thought he was able to scare them away. Just then, he heard an explosion emanate. What was that thing that I kept saying in the documentary over and over again? They couldn't figure it out.
What happened?
I forget, anyway, emanate from outside. He ran over to his window and saw the future building collapsing into itself as a ball of flames engulfed the laboratory. He became scared, seeing a superpower in the city go down half a second. Truly let him know how vulnerable he was. The facade he slowly built up in his mind, that he was all-powerful, began to crumble as the doors being hit continued. Oh, I need to burp for so long.
I'm gay. Chapter 14.
Last chapter, we're here!
Well, not, there's still an epilogue.
Shut up!
Okay. Chapter 14, My Last Stand, Robert Inkwell. The metal door started to give as each hit sent a shock throughout the room. Robert had no way out. He was trapped inside his office. He looked down at the crowd below, seeing the thousands of people wanting him gone. Robert's heart sank as he realized that he had lost. And he knew what he had to do. He slowly opened a desk drawer. In it was a small handgun and a singular bullet. He loaded the bullet into the gun as the bang of the door and the mob's yells from outside filled his head. He closed his eyes and took a deep breath, letting the sounds fade away from his mind as he put the gun to his head and pulled the trigger. Dang. He lost and straight up killed himself.
What a loser.
He's like me for real. Whenever I lose an argument, that's what I do. You not know that? I've done that 3 times in the past week. I don't know what I'm saying. Anyways.
Please read.
Make me. His world went dark and silent. He felt nearly weightless. I almost said weightless. Yeah, he opened his eyes and he was surrounded by darkness with a large metal box in the distance. He tried to move, but he felt completely paralyzed. A cold, lifeless voice enveloped him. He felt in his chest. One way or another, you'll have to start finding out that life isn't what you make of it, it said. What are you? Were the only words Robert could force out of his throat. The man that covered your world in crimson, he responded. Murdering for greed and power, going against Nature. Ain't that the computer guys? Nature.
Alva Nature?
Oh, yeah. Silencing your people, words are not enough to tell the atrocities, he continued. The punisher becomes the punished, quoth the raven, nevermore. Robert became dizzy as his mind went dark once more. This final chapter is like the best.
Oh, it's so good. I'm gonna...
Don't. Please stop doing whatever you're doing. His eyelids felt heavy as a blinding light passed through them. Robert opened his eyes, greeted with his old bedroom. He sat up, throwing open his curtain and seeing the city was back to how it was. He stared out his window, thankful his old life was back. The TV in his room became louder in his mind as the morning news began. He soon heard a familiar voice coming from the speakers. At the end of the year, we are proud to announce that since we were able to rid the city of hunger, we will start shifting our focus to helping the scientific community find cures for life-threatening diseases and helping supply hospitals with better funding. Robert started to forget. His mind began to erase the last few years as though they had never happened. He became bitter, angry at the world. I deserve that throne, he muttered out loud. He thought for a minute before opening up his cell phone to give Jeremy an apology. Once the call was all finished up, Robert pulled the box out from under his bed. In it was a small handgun with only 3 rounds. He grabbed and stuffed it in his coat pocket, knowing today he would get his revenge.
That's so good!
He went to a mirror glitch! That's what happened. That's canonically. He went to a mirror glitch. He didn't, like, go back. He went through a mirror glitch. It's like Bendy.
If Bendy was good. Also, I just got a virus on my computer, apparently. What has Cryon done?
Sorry, my bad. Anyways, epilogue.
Do I read this, or...
You like, read it, because you're...
Half.
You want to read half?
I mean, I can go to...
Do, like, the top half, and I'll do the bottom half.
Okay. We rise up against the people who try to whittle us down.
Whittle.
Kiss fire was never... Kiss... Is it... What? Whittle? Is that how you say it?
No, you said whittle, but it sounds funny to me for some reason.
Kiss fire never goes down without a fight, and we will never will. That's something that either Michael or Justin would say.
These nuts.
Is that like, who says this?
Somebody, I don't know.
Is it Michael? Is it like Michael, or is it like between
them? I don't know. I just wanted something to cool to put. So you.
I mean, that's probably something Michael or Justin would say, because you know.
If then who said it? That's your decision. I don't really care.
Michael.
Yeah, your call.
Michael.
Well, all right, Michael said it. There you go.
Unknown is now Michael. When you make the remake, or if you ever do, Michael. Boom.
Okay.
One final hit of the doors was enough to break them open. The doors fell off their hinges as the Legion rushed through inside Robert's office. One of them threw a fire extinguisher to the ground as they saw his blood splatter on the windows and his lifeless corpse laying on the back black hardwood floor. One of them busted out a window from Robert's office, yelling to everybody down below that Robert was dead.
Everyone was evacuated out of the tower as the final charges were set. Everyone from their roofs watched as an explosion erupted out of the tower. Shattering glass and stone covered the vicinity as the supports on the building began to fail. People began to cheer as the rebar failed and the tower began to collapse. Dust filled the barren streets as what remained of the tower went up in flames. The last pieces of the skyscraper hit the ground as the area was filled with rubble. Cryon was now no more. The logo that once hung up on the side of the building was now laying in a pile of rubble. The death of a titan. The end of a madman. The end of Cryon, Inc.
Woo! We did it!
I'm gay! Do you want to read the back text?
The welcome to Cryon, Inc.?
Yeah.
Again, we could literally make this into like a small book.
It is our small book, you idiot.
I mean like an actual like paperback thing.
I tried, but it's too hard. It's too expensive.
I'm not sure we can do something.
Maybe.
Alright.
Are you gonna read it?
Sorry. Welcome to Cryon, Inc. Jeremy Cryon gets a chance to start up Cryon, Inc., a business to support the people of Kishfire. I said Kishfire, dang it. When Jeremy is murdered in cold blood and his good friend Robert Inkwell is put in charge, he soon becomes power hungry. He seeks to rule Kishfire and its people through horrifying science experiments. Step into the dark mind of Robert Inkwell as he crowns himself the god of this alien city. Also, I'm just now realizing the epilogue the final chapter is revealed that's when it's revealed. My bad, forgot about that part.
You're a goober.
I haven't read the book in a while.
I'm gay. Anyways, are you ready for the next part of the stream? The official history of Cryonic slideshow.
Do you want me to stay?
Do you want to stay?
I mean, it's up to you, man. It's your stream.
I don't really I'll care. If you want to stay, you can stay.
All right, I can give some more context.
Yeah, you can give some more context. Hey, and I actually, before I do this, I have like a thing. I have like an entire like document written out.
That was fun, man. Sad. I love that. That makes me more excited for the thing.
Yeah. All right. Chat, are we all ready for the history of Cryon, Inc.?
Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain.
I can hear you.
Hear these nuts in your mouth.
Are you still trying to share your screen, or do you need me to, like...
What happened?
You're still sharing your screen. I'm not sure if you did that on purpose or not.
I don't really... watch it. I don't care. Yeah.
I'm just saying. All right.
All right. History of Cryon, Inc. Now...
You're still on intermission. Oh, never mind.
No, I'm not. Shut up.
The stream lag.
Alright. Now, before we get into Cryon, Inc., first, what you're going to need to know about is TGC records. Now, before I was not TGP, I was not TGC Online. And during that, I had TGC records. That was when I made music. That was terrible. But yeah, I made music. And it had this, like, entire storyline for it. And, at the time, I had 3 albums. And, it was grand. It was cool. This graphic design is horrible. This was, like, 3 years ago.
Was it 3 years?
We're not remaking it. But, I was coming up on my 4th album. It was actually before I, finished the 4th album, Total War. That eventually came out. And the plan was, hang on, what's the next? Okay. The plan was to have 5 albums, and that would be, like, one, like, era of the story, and then I would do another era. And I had to come up with the idea for a 6th album, and that idea was Lance of Cryon. Now, what Lance of Cryon initially was, It was supposed to be... Actually, do I have the story? I do. So, this is what Cryon initially was. This is the first time I ever thought about the name Cryon. So, this is like... 13-year-old me writing, so it's horrible. Bear with me. Land of Cryon, one singular land. Cryon was a planet frozen over, hurtling endlessly through the galaxy. The eternal flame, an item that holds endless amount of power, was said to be located in the caves of Cryon. It was an item no mortal would dare touch. Its heat was enough to melt flesh and bone. The only thing that could live on the frozen wasteland was simple single-celled orc creatures. So, yeah, that was first, that was the first thing of Cryon ever. And, eventually I started to not like that. And, after the, fourth album release, I was like, you know, I want to make this into something cool. So I made this logo.
Ooh.
Don't say ooh. Don't lie. This looks like trash.
I'm trying to get the chat hype.
Don't get the chat hype. This looks like trash. So, this was the first Cryon logo. And, I think that same day... Was it the same day? May 26th? No, it was a day later I realized, hey, that logo sucks. Let's do a new one. And, that's Cryon logo. That was the Cryon logo for a good long time. And, then after the fourth album finished up, I decided, you know what? Hang on. All right. I decided, you know what? I actually don't want four albums in one era. I don't want five albums in one era. I want four. So I decided that the next album I would be doing was Cryon Inc. Cryon Inc. Let's try that again. This sucks. This is terrible. This is like marginally better. Now, I was super excited to do Cryon Inc. And I even had a deluxe edition planned.
Okay,
and then,
fair, can I say something?
Yeah, say something.
That deluxe edition kind of slaps.
It does slap. It is a nice design. So yeah, I was gonna, so I had Cryon Inc. all set up, and that was my track list that I had. Do you want to read it out if you want?
Fueled by fire, automation, our own colony, final vice, beyond hope. Severed ties, tainted, burned utopia to ash, Cryon Inc.
So that was initially the first track list for a Cryon album. And it was cool. I was really excited to do this, but then I decided, you know what? This sucks. So a message from TGC Entertainment. That was like the parent company of TGC Records. Hey gang, I'm publishing this announcement to let you know that any future TGC Records material will be canceled and not worked on. TGC will also not be worked on again, as I have no passion for these two. While his efforts are canceled, TGC Games will still be active in making content. While TGC Records may be done, I have focused my efforts to helping my friend Arcade Gamer and all his projects. Ooh, I hope you all understand. Take care. Now, TGC Records turned into, Jupitr Entertainment. I don't know why it's positive sense, but yeah. Now, I wanted to do this idea one day, so I messaged Arcade while he was sharing, Tax Season 2 stuff, I'm pretty sure, and I said, do you know what you could do? And I said, remember that Cryon Inc. thing I said you could, let me retry that. Remember that Cryon thing I said that if you needed a story you could use? And then you said, go on. Why don't you read your lines? Because you. Like, you can make this new separate story or something that goes into tech later down the line. Like a giant plot twist where you find out that these stories are in the same world. Or there could be multiple spin-off stories that are all interconnected like the MCU.
Dot.
No, I said it's being called ambitious. This was before, all that was before the project series and then all that. So, I have foreshadowing.
You have the slide where I initially took out Tack out of the story and like the reaction to that?
I do not.
I feel like that's pretty vital to the story as well.
Well, I'll maybe pull that up. I was reading that like literally yesterday because I wanted to get mad again. Whenever I want to get mad, I just read that and then I just get furious. So that's the first mention to Cryon to Arcade. That was September 7th, 2021. That was a long time ago. And then eventually he gave me the okay. This was like a good while later. This was October 5th. And I wrote the initial first draft of Cryon. I don't think anybody's ever seen this besides me and Arcade. So this is the first draft ever of Cryon. In a city built by two madmen covered in a crimson veil lay a skyscraper with the scratch metal logo hanging off it, reading Cryon Inc. Before the city was burned to ash, Cryon led the way of the future, building hospitals and other services to the people. Now it was a corrupted, evil empire that towered over everything, releasing chemicals into the clouds so that when it rained, anybody caught in the rain would see horrible monstrosities. Cryon would lie and say they would provide people with shelter from the rain. When people would come in, they would knock them out cold and conduct experiments on them, testing the humans that trusted them to the limits, using their blood and organs for the chemicals they would release into the sky. When they were all used up, throw their bodies in an incinerator. And then I sent that to... Oh, it doesn't have the thing where I sent it to you? That's stupid. I sent it to him, and he was like, oh, that's pretty cool. I like that. And then I did another thing. Do you want to read this? Because I probably won't be reading all of these.
In a city plagued by darkness, covered over by a crimson fog, there is just a skyscraper towering over every other building with a large logo hanging on the side. Cryon Inc., a once peaceful and
hospitable.
That's a word?
That is a word.
Hospitable company has become overturned to be an empire built off blood. Jeremy Cryon started a company with one goal, comfort and peace to others. He built a tower, hired dozens of workers to provide help anybody and everybody. After due time, his focus went to research and technology to provide better care and service for the millions. Jeremy passed away, gee, wonder how, and it was ruled over by his close friend Robert Inkwell. He became obsessed with controlling the city.
Don't show that. Jesus, Lord. Continue.
I saw his porn chat.
You didn't. That's a lie.
Okay.
What?
Jeremy passed away and it was ruled over by his close friend, Robert Equill. He became obsessed with controlling the city and soon started experimenting with humans, ayo. He started up a company named
Safefelt. You can
Seth
do
McFarland.
It. Seth McFarland.
Safefelt toys to hide experiments. Holy crap, why was I having Cryon?
Don't do it's not I don't even think Seth voices Peter.
He does.
Does he?
He voices every character, bro.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Stewie, Quagmire,
I'm sorry, I don't know my Peter, Family Guy lore, excuse me.
I know my Family Guy lore.
Is that it?
Sorry.
No, I'm genuinely asking.
Okay. Let's start controlling the CZR experiment with a toy. Start up a company named Safefelt Toys to hide experiments, meshing human beings with robotic parts and releasing them in the forest to see how they last. The forest is always there. Holy crap, I just realized. Forest was always a part of the story.
The forest, there was a part of the story. For some reason.
People don't know yet, and they won't know for a while. But the forest is really important for the fourth album.
And canonically, apparently for some reason, it is also the forest where they find the shed that has Carmen in it in Kip 2.
Is that actually canon?
I guess, since Safefelt Toys is a thing. I mean, technically, it's an alternate universe, because, like, Jeremy doesn't have a son in this one, or Robert doesn't have a son in it. Okay. I make some weird lore. Anyways, you're done reading?
No. I forgot. Meshing human beings with the robotic parts raised them in the forest, see how long they last. One day, the city was destroyed, however.
Sorry.
One day the city was destroyed. However, Cryon Inc. survived. The city was rebuilt, and now Inkwell could take his experiments to the extreme, kidnapping people and using their flesh and bones to create hallucinogens, which would be flown into the sky when it would rain. Anybody outside would see horrible creatures. Cryon would lie and say that they would provide people with shelter from the rain. People could come in, they would knock them out in cold and use them for the next batch. Once the bodies were used up, they would throw them away like trash. So you can see a lot of differences in that.
Yeah, there's a few differences. This was only the second draft. This was like October 6th, I believe. So yeah, there's a few. I could do. Ooh, no, I don't want to do that. Hang on. If the presentation might... Okay, never mind. I'm stupid. Hang on, chat. This is my first time doing this. Alright.
He needs a little...
Now, yes, that was the second draft. And now, I sent that to Arcade, and he was like, yeah. And then I was like, are we doing this? And he was like, yeah, so welcome to the Metal Knot era. Now, since I was going to be in Metal Knot, he wanted me to have an album and an EP for some reason. Or was it... Or whoever it was...
You didn't suggest the EP.
Oh, yeah, I suggested the EP. We were going to do an album. Never mind. Anyways, EP track list. This is Cryon Inc. This is what the track list was going to be for the EP. Our Own Empire, Beyond Hope, Burned Utopia, Cryon Inc. Slated 2022-2023. See how good that came out. And along with the EP, I had a nice little cover. Ain't that nice. Also, it's Birth of the Killer now. I don't know. Yeah, I have two
Can
names.
Can I be completely honest?
Listen, Birth of a Killer is actually slightly good.
No.
Yes.
The top Birth of a looks fine, but the Killer looks completely out of place.
No, it doesn't. It adds coolness. And while we're at it, Cryon Inc. was going to be the name of the album, so I had to make a track list for that. And I also... I also decided to remake the logo. I don't know where that came from. I tried to ignore that. That is something. Please tell me that looks bad.
It looks terrible.
Thank you. Okay. You know, to my credit, I like the lightning.
I didn't even notice lightning.
Anyways, Cryon Inc. We got a new logo. This is the newest logo. It's probably never going to change because I like the logo too much. And I made a teaser for the tracklist / EP. I forget which one it was. Hang on. It's for the EP. Don't trust that dang rain 2022. This looks terrible. This was my banner for a while, I'm pretty sure.
Terrible. Why'd you use the Metlux text? Anything to make it stand out. It just, and then 2022 is the most basic font you can find on the font.
Shut up. Yeah. Alright, and then with that, I wrote chapter 2. How did I misspell unknown?
I'm not reading that.
Yeah, I don't plan on you reading that. The chapters get longer and longer from here, so.
Jesus.
Yeah. And then we have the first three teasers of, the Cryon story, which were all made November 6th, which this one...
Ayo.
Yeah, so originally the story was going to be where Jeremy dies and then Robert decides that he wants Jeremy back, so he builds a hybrid and puts his soul or consciousness or whatever into the hybrid. And then, actually, cool little secret, if you, like, physically stand up and look at your monitor from down below, you can kind of see it says, "Welcome back, Jeremy," below the 37% complete.
Can you?
Yeah. I mean, you can see it, like, if you look, like, super close to your monitor.
I can't see it at all.
Well, it's there.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah, there, you see it. It's, like, super faint, because I didn't want to, you know, spoil anything. But that's the first story teaser. This is the second. I'm 99% sure this is actually a cutout of Mr. House? Is that Mr. House from New Vegas?
Does he have a full body shot? I couldn't find any.
I think he has a full body shot. Because if he doesn't, then who is this?
It's my mother.
It's just some random person. And then this one.
Should we explain why we keep saying Mr. House a lot?
Yeah, because that's what I've said canonically that he looks like.
To have already in the stream.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, canonically, my vision for Robert is that he looks like Mr. House from New Vegas. So that's why we keep mentioning New Vegas. And then here's this one. This text was initially going to be in the story. But I stood before the walls of a titan, and once the doors opened and I stepped in, I saw a future of darkness. The walls were plain metal, and it felt as though I stepped into another world. I stepped inside the birth of a killer. Now, apparently this is for the story. It was hard to track down, like, what everything was for. But yeah, this was for the story, not for the EP of the same name. I don't know. And then after that, the EP's second cover is this. Is this. So this looks better. Apparently it's back to the name Cryon Inc. I don't know. I wrote this like bullet points like a month ago to get prepared for this. I think it's right. I'm like 99% sure it's right. There's a lot of name swatching. So yeah. And then a few days later, do you know what came about? On November 17th? I decided, you know what? I kind of miss TGC Entertainment. So what am I going to do? Jupitr Entertainment, baby. That's the Woo! First. That was all before Jupitr Entertainment. And then I got excited. So I made an album teaser. And yeah, I still kind of like this. I hope this is in like... this gets into the Cryon story or whatever in some form. And yeah, I made that the same day. And then on the 13th of December, I made the fourth story teaser for Cryon. And then it's the quote, "The Raven Nevermore." Initially, it was going to show up on his laptop, I think. Which it turned into the TV then. I don't really know. And yeah, I made chapters 3, 4, and 5 on December 16th. These are like early versions of the chapter. If you want to read them, you can. I'm not going to read them out, though. For anybody, I meant for anybody watching the VOD.
You guys should join the TGP Discord server, and we're gonna be posting the entire album tonight.
The entire Cryon album tonight that we haven't even started.
Sure, we have. Hold on.
And then we had a Cryon. We had the chapter 6. I thought we were. Oh yeah, that's the next one. So this is chapter 6 that was made on Christmas. I had nothing else going on apparently. And then Cryon story, the fifth Cryon story teaser, same day. This morning we went to a room and a capacitor must have blown in Project H-17's head. May set us back a bit, so we're quite sorry. Had him row section 19. That was what the actual note looked like. So, big facts. And then
why is a 19 like that?
I don't know. I think I don't think the font liked numbers, so I think that's why. And then I made chapter 7, 8, 9 on February 3rd. So over 2 months after the last one. And, I didn't start chapter 9, but I started it. I started chapter 9. I didn't finish it, but I started it.
That is chapter 9 in its entirety.
Yeah, that's chapter 9. And then, after that, well, how many days was it? It was, like 12 days after.
I don't mean to interrupt you here.
Yeah.
But when I see a chapter 9, I think about the joke album list, album tracks for the TAC. I am Jerry, I look so fly, I make rain, I love sunrise.
What?
I don't know why, when I saw chapter 9, I'm an unstoppable, indestructible god. My mind raced to that.
Your mind raced to like a weird track list?
You were the one who sent it to me.
I don't think I did.
I'll prove it.
I don't remember that. You're gonna have to send that, and I'll show it after. But then, after this, like 12 days later, I made a new story outline, or I made a new album art. We're showing that first. So that was gonna be the official album art for the, what's that? I believe that's the EP, or no, that's the album. Never mind. I'm stupid. I said album art. I don't know why. I was like, maybe this is the EP. But then a new story.
Man,
never mind. Apparently, I didn't make a new story outline. I made chapters 10, 11, and 12. This is the draft. And then I made the Cryon story logo. Never mind. I have to really get my notes in place. So this is the album the story outline. I'm not good with how I do this, so yeah, bear with me. So this is the new outline for what was going to be the Cryon story. The people left in this facility started making underground tunnels to stay clear of rainfall. This was after chapter 10, like after that. Robert finds out the plans and plans to gas the tunnels full of rainfall, and then some dude finds out about what rainfall does and the gassing plan. he's able to get outside in a hazmat suit and warns people. People seal the tunnels, and then when Robert does gas them, they put two and two together and figure out Robert made the rain go oopsie poopsie. There's a new protest. This time they break into the tower and the scientists revolt. Robert locks himself into his office and people destroy the thing that launches rainfall. He knows he's effed. He pulls a handgun out of his desk, kills himself. Story repeats from the day he got fired from Cryon. And then, yeah. Before that, he gets out back in time and he talks to the Titan that made... Oh, yeah. That's when he talks to James. And then, yeah. That's the story outline. I don't know what's coming next, because apparently this is like a reaching my hand into the box and seeing what happens. Okay, next.
New logo. Oh wait,
no. This is actually the logo for the Cryon story. This is gonna be the original thing, and then along with that, I made the first album art. I'm pretty sure I showed this off. I don't remember.
That is a book art.
That was the original book. What did I say?
Album.
No, this is the book art. That was gonna be the cover for the book. And then after that, I made, I believe, yeah, that's another teaser. Where am I? Oh, okay. What is that? Story change. So if everything goes right, this should be where they introduce Legion. Okay. 5:01 a.m. late night thought. You know how it is. Dude, entire change of plans for Cryon. I sent the Starcade. We're going to make the new operation called Legion, where he makes robots out of the people died to rainfall, so basically like a hybrid situation, and he to get the people that are remaining still alive out into the rain, and then James Butler says, "F you, Robert," and stops the rain in Legion. The people go after him. Hilarity ensues. So that was originally what was going to be happened. What happened.
I mean, Legion is made by James Butler, and it's a revolt. But
yeah, you know. Yeah, there's a few changes, and then chapter story. Is that what happens? Okay, this is what happens. This is the sixth teaser. Punisher becomes punished. Quote the Raven, nevermore. That was the sixth teaser, and it was cool. Then after that, chapter edits. Is that what is next? Nope. good thing I'm cross referencing. Next is a second new book art. I like this a lot, actually.
I don't think it looks too different. I mean, it looks a bit darker, but that's it.
Hang on, let me go back. This one, there's like a lot more grain. Kind of, this one has more like scan lines in the back. Less grain.
Wait, it's a red mist.
That red mist was always there, I'm pretty sure.
No, I'm just saying, the red mist, never realized that.
I never realized that either.
I originally thought you just used the taxis and or one of the Welcome to Future.
I did that, and I just changed the hue, and then that's what that is.
And it worked out, apparently.
It did. And then after this, what is it? I believe this is a story teaser, which, that's supposed to be the hybrid on the left. And on the right, it's super faint, but there is like a little poem. And I can't read it all because I decided to make it super dark. But it's there. You can kind of make out some text.
Okay, I'm gonna be completely honest with you, TGP.
Okay. It does maybe look a little stupid. I'm gonna be completely.
It looks like a South Park character, like a Canadian from South Park.
It does. This is not official anymore.
Hey guy, how's it going?
This is not official anymore. And then after that, I decided to make the second or final Cryon Inc. logo because I decided. Why make the album named Cryon Inc. when it's just going to be based off the book? Why don't I make the book named Cryon Inc. and then name the album something else? And then with that, I made the final book art. This is what appears and everything, and it's cool. So now we're getting super close to the release date. And I said coming soon because like that's when I started like writing a lot. Because these past few months when I was just making like logos and teasers, I couldn't like think of anything. I was going through a bunch of like writer's block. I didn't write anything for like 3 months, it must have been. Hang on, let me see. Sixth teaser. Second book cover. When was like changes? So February 15th, I made 10, 11, 12. And then, or no, April 22nd. And then it's May. So, yeah, about, like, 4 months, I think. Something like that. So, this is going to be... So, I was like excited. I was like, oh, it's finally coming out. And then I was about finished with it, and I made shooting for June 3rd, 2022 because I didn't know if I was going to go through another writer's block. And yeah, I was super excited. And then finally, what happened?
Wasn't there like a thing a bet we made, say if you did it?
Yeah, you said that you would write like a series of books if I was able to get Cryon out before June. And this is May, first of all. Right now we're in May. This is like May 17th or whatever. We're in May. If you said I was able to finish Cryon by June, you would write that series of books? And you want to know something? May 14th, 2022, at 4 a.m., I messaged you. Dude, I finished it. The story's done. Oh my lord, I'm so happy. I was so scared I wasn't going to be able to get this out by June, but now it's definite. I finished it before June, and I haven't seen you hold up your end of the bargain. So what do you got to say about that?
Once I finish tech, the thing I'm working on currently, I'm not going to say anything about because I only told you about it.
Uh-huh.
Once I finish those two, I'll start considering stuff.
Sure.
I can only focus on one thing at a time right now, dude.
Sure. Well, and then with that, Cryon got out. I released it on June 3rd. And
today?
June 3rd today. Well, actually, yesterday. Because now it's 12:27.
It's no longer special.
It's no longer special. But I released this technically yesterday, a year ago. And then, with that, let's get to the future of Cryon Inc.
Oh! I didn't know about this!
Yeah, so I won't be showing off anything definite, but this is stuff that might probably happen. So first off, I'll give you a little corner of a logo. And this is all you get. You're not getting anything else. And then
I know what it is.
You know what it is. I've showed you the logo. I haven't worked on this in a while, but I'm hoping it's coming. And the next thing, it's a little revamped like Dirty Cryon logo for something. And you know what this is for. You know what this is for.
Spoilers alert, it's cool.
Okay, I thought you were going to say it. And now, there's one big thing that I am super Arcade hasn't even heard of this. I am very proud to announce Cryon 2, baby! Let's go!
Yeah, Cryon 2!
We're working on it! I'm not. I'm not making Cryon 2.
Explain what Cryon 2 is.
Cryon 2, you made actually a really good, story, thing in your meme trailer where you said that he was gonna escape the mirror glitch and do fun stuff. So if I do a Cryon 2, that's probably when it's gonna be. But I'm not gonna be a Cryon 2. He kills Psy Gangnam Style.
Listen. He kills James Butler, takes over the throne, one that he owns, so gonna go before he can't take it away. What a shame. And then he splooges everywhere.
I'm firing you. Okay, but real talk, if I do ever do another Cryon book that's not a rewrite of the original Cryon book, it's probably not gonna be a Cryon 2. It's probably not gonna be a sequel. It's probably gonna be another set version.
Hear me out.
Yeah.
How about we go right for a Cryon and do another company inside of Kissfire?
We already got too many companies.
Nudge. There's only two, Dungweed.
I am not writing futures. I got other things to do. Alright. Well, with that, that is the end of the presentation and the end of the stream. So, what would you rate that presentation out of 10?
I'll give that a 9.5.
Aw, thank you, man. Alright, folks. Well, that is the end of the Cryon anniversary stream. Do you have any... Oh, yeah, read Cryon Inc., by the way. bit.ly/CryonInc.
Yeah, it's amazing.
You probably don't have to, because we read it, but if you don't want to hear us...
If you want an actual experience without, the funny bits, we'll be getting that on Metlux sometime in the future.
Hopefully.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Maybe.
And, oh, no, I have to do this.
You lost the bet. You have to.
Can we just announce what the bet was?
If you want to announce what the bet was, you can go right ahead.
Okay, so what was it originally?
Let me look it up really quick. Give me half a second. Cryon. Let me see that. Hang on, I think... Oh, yeah. So, I said that... how do I say this without spoiling anything? Because this is, like, a bunch of Jupiter... This is involving a bunch of Jupiter products. Products? Games. Oh, I left the call. Sorry. My bad. Well, it's a bunch of messages. I'll just read them out. So, I announced... I ran a poll on Twitter saying I want to make two games, but I can only work on one of them. So which one would you be? Option one or option two? Arcade thought he knew what option one was, and he said that if that didn't win, he would do something. And technically it was just the name of the old thing. So he lost that bet. So yeah, explain to them what you have to do.
I have to put in a lot of money into making a kind of a picture video of me reading out the Cryon Ink story.
Like an animated, like...
Not animated, but...
Like Animaniac. Animaniac? Is that what it's called?
What?
Or just like still pictures.
It's just still pictures.
Kind of like an audiobook kind of thing, but with like illustrations.
Yeah. Kinda.
You had to spend a lot of money on that. How much did you say you had to spend on that? Like $200?
Maybe a lot more, depending on how much Shard's willing to... How much me and Shard talk it out.
I love winning bets. I love winning bets.
With every penny, though. It's going to be awesome. I'm probably even going to get some actors on.
Ooh, actors.
You know, we could have, you know, more realistic depictions and better... Just to make it... I'm going to be putting my heart and soul into this. This is going to be very big. I wanted to do it before this point, but...
Now you have to.
It wasn't possible.
Now you have to.
I have to do it.
All right.
I've announced it. I have to do it now.
Well...
Yeah, hopefully, call me soon on the Metlook channel.
Well, Arcade, is there anything you want to say before you bounce? Oh, sorry.
Can I say anything not Cryon-related?
You can say stuff Cryon-related, just like advertise or whatever. Last words on the stream.
The Anime Curse season 4 / final season is 5 episodes done and most likely will be done by August of 2023.
Poggers.
I'm saying. Before December, expect it to be. It's going to be out this year. That's all I'm saying. All
right. Out this year. So... Alright, I'm gonna leave the call, so take care, man. Well,
thanks for having me on.
You don't forget it. I don't know why I said that so
menacingly. I wasn't supposed to be on.
Yeah, you weren't supposed to be on because you were being a little turd munchkin before stream.
Yeah, I was a little...
But you were a good boy, so I forgive you.
Don't say it like that. That sounds very sexually overtoned.
No, it doesn't. Oh, actually, yes, it does. Never mind. Never mind. Alright, I am leaving the call. Goodbye, Arcade. You weirdo making everything sexual.
Bye-bye!
Markiplier. Alright, chat. I think that was a good stream. We could have... How long was it? We spent 30 minutes on the presentation. Holy lord. But, yeah. I guess that you probably did hear a little bit of the song I was gonna do for the outro. So sorry about that if you got jump scared with the drum. But yeah. Let me start the outro and I will say my things and leave and you will see me on Monday. If you guys enjoyed what you saw, make sure to follow the channel, subscribe to the VOD channel, so if you want you can go watch this later and all of my future streams later. Join the Discord server so you're notified when you're live, you talk with me in the community, and all that fun stuff. Join Final FM, close the Discord server on Earth, play Journey Home to 1.3.1 update out now. Follow my socials, watch Shack Read Cryon, listen to Encore, listen to Failed, you, new song by Arcade, and now listen to Believing Metal Song now by Arcade, listen to Let the Sun Rise in Metal Song now by Arcade, watch the Fracture FNAF Malfunction and FNAF Malware Detected all out now. New FNAF series is not in production yet, at least not publicly. Oopsie poopsie, I might have something by accident. It's fine. Yeah. Journey Home to 1.3.1 update on now. Also, Spooky Scary Maze Game. Go download those. Squeeze Adventure 3 Across the Cosmos releases this June 6, 2023. So in 2 days, only 2 days, you get to experience the final game in the Squeeze Adventure trilogy. So be excited for that, hopefully. And yeah, Uno Frenzy, June 21st. See who's better at Uno, me or Arcade. Last year was me. Hopefully it's me this year again. If it is, I'm going to laugh a lot. And I think that is it. Also, I need you to the bunker next week. I'm very excited to do that. So, yeah. If you all enjoyed what you saw, make sure to like, follow, and whatever. And I will see you all in the next stream. Have a good night, everyone. I'll talk to you tomorrow. And I might do another one for the 2-year anniversary of Cryon, but I don't know. All right, I'm gonna go. Take care, everyone. Have a good night. I'll talk to you Monday.